if f of x equals 2x plus 3 and g of x equals the quantity x minus 3 divided by 2, we want to determine f of g of x as well as g of f of x, and then determine if f of x and g of x are inverses. If we look at our notes for a moment, if f inverse of f of x equals x and f of f inverse of x equals x, then the two functions are inverses of one another, which means in our case, if the two composite functions are equal to x, then f of x and g of x are inverses. If either of the composite functions is not equal to x, then the two functions are not inverses of one another. To determine f of g of x, we begin with the inner function g of x, and since there's no numerical value as an input for g of x, we replace g of x with the function rule of the quantity x minus 3 divided by 2, which indicates f of g of x is equal to f of the quantity x minus 3 divided by 2, and the quantity x minus 3 divided by 2 now becomes the input into the function f of x. So now we substitute the quantity x minus 3 divided by 2 for x in f of x, which gives us 2 times the quantity x minus 3 divided by 2 plus 3, and now we simplify. If it's helpful, we can write 2 as 2 divided by 1. Notice 2 divided by 2 simplifies to 1. Simplifying, we have x minus 3 plus 3, which is equal to x. Now, it's not enough for one of the composite functions to be equal to x to determine if two functions are inverses. We have to find both composite functions. So now we determine g of f of x. We begin with the inner function f of x. And once again, because there's no numerical value as an input for f of x, we replace f of x with the function rule of 2x plus 3, which indicates g of f of x equals g of the quantity 2x plus 3, and 2x plus 3 becomes the input for the function g of x. Substituting 2x plus 3 for x in g of the quantity 2x plus 3 is equal to the quantity 2x plus 3 minus 3, all divided by 2. Simplifying, 2x plus 3 minus 3 simplifies to 2x, giving us 2x divided by 2, which also equals x. Because both composite functions are equal to x, we now know f of x and g of x are inverses of one another. Number 3, the answer is yes. Let's take a look at a second example. Here we're given f of x equals 3x minus 9, and g of x equals x divided by 3 plus 9. Once again, we want to find f of g of x as well as g of f of x. So once again, to determine f of g of x, we begin with the inner function g of x, and because there's no numerical value as an input, we replace g of x with the function rule, indicating f of g of x equals f of x divided by 3 plus 9, and now x divided by 3 plus 9 becomes the input for the function f of x. So now we substitute x divided by 3 plus 9 for x in f of x, which gives us 3 times the quantity x divided by 3 plus 9 minus 9. To simplify, we distribute 3. 3 times x divided by 3 is equal to x plus 3 times 9 is 27 minus 9. Simplifying, f of g of x equals x plus 18. Because f of g of x is not equal to x, we know right away f of x and g of x are not inverses. So we can go ahead and go to number 3 and enter no. The two functions are not inverses. But let's also determine g of f of x. To determine g of f of x, we begin with the inner function f of x and replace f of x with the function rule of 3x minus 9, indicating g of f of x is equal to g of the quantity 3x minus 9, and 3x minus 9 becomes the input into the function g, which indicates we substitute 3x minus 9 for x in g of x, which gives us the quantity 3x minus 9 divided by 3 plus 9. To simplify the quotient here, we can either factor out 3 from the numerator and then simplify, or write the quotient as two separate fractions, as 3x divided by 3 minus 9 divided by 3 plus 9. Simplifying, 3 divided by 3 simplifies to 1, leaving us with x. 9 divided by 3 is 3. So we have x minus 3 plus 9, indicating g of f of x is equal to x plus 6. And we already know, because both composite functions are not equal to x, the two functions are not inverses of one another. I hope you found this helpful.